when I crave something sweet, I would go and grab a Snickers bar. And, okay, that would be the end. Okay, well, I could have an orange, too, because that's on the list. And you know what? Well, at the beginning, it would be close your eyes and just pretend it's a Snickers bar and down it. And then it got easier and easier.
The KU Diet Project for People with Physical Disabilities.
Hi, I'm Amanda Reichard.
And I'm Muriel Saunders. We're directing a weight loss program for people with physical disabilities. This is a three-year project funded by NIDRR, and participants are follow one of two diet programs. One is a program very similar to the My Pyramid, or now called My Plate diet, and the second is a diet that involves meal replacements, frozen entrees to be exact, and protein shakes that were donated by HMR products. They also have what's called a stoplight chart, which shows them in color coding those things that are low in calories. Those are green items. We chart them as green light items. Yellow ones to be slightly careful about, and red light items, those things that they should avoid.
One of the components that's important to both the diets is that participants meet with a dietitian or an exercise physiologist at least once a month to review their goals, to review ideas for continuing to make changes and replacements in their diet that work better for them. So this provides a sense of social support throughout the entire project. Many of the participants in our study also, in addition to being overweight, have diabetes. And an important outcome of the study is that in addition to losing weight, they have been able to get their blood sugar under control and manage their diabetes through exercise and diet.
Karen Magliaro is one of the participants who is losing weight and improving her health. After 9 months in the 18-month study, she had lost 46 pounds and was able to reduce her diabetes medication.
My weight's gone down from doing that, but my health has gotten much better. Cutting off all the sugars and the cookies and the garbage, my blood sugars have gone way down. I was doing almost 80 units of insulin at night before bed. Now I'm down to 20.
Although participants are not required to exercise, we encourage them to do so and provide them with ideas for accessible exercise. Participant Lou Reed is also improving her health as she loses weight. After 12 months in the 18-month study, she had lost 22 pounds.
Yeah, my blood sugar used to be real high. It used to be in the 200s. My blood sugars are now in the 90s. 80s and the 90s, so my blood sugar is way down there. And it has been since I've been on this program.
The fact that people who are morbidly obese or obese, who have many complicating factors in their lives, multiple chronic conditions in addition to obesity, the fact that they are able to lose weight despite all those factors, and that those with diabetes are able to get the diabetes under control, is testament to this model working for this population in particular. Ultimately, we hope that Medicaid and other health insurance companies will want to provide similar services for their beneficiaries. So we're collecting data and using the Medicaid administrative claims data to examine how the weight loss and participation in this study has influenced their healthcare utilization and health outcomes, so that we can use that as argument for reasons why they should support this programs like this, preventive programs.
We support these people on the diet for a total of a year and a half. And during that time, they report that they begin to feel better and they begin to make lifestyle changes. At the end of the year and a half, we hope that those lifestyle changes are ingrained in their daily lives.
So now I keep fresh fruits and vegetables in the refrigerator. I get the celery home and I clean it and keep it in a bowl of water. And when I want something to crunch on, I'll go and grab a stalk of celery instead of grabbing maybe a cookie or a bag of chips.
I'm not as grouchy. I feel good about myself. You know, I see the weight coming off. You know, being overweight is very stressful. Mm-hmm. You know, and I see, you know, and if I want it, it's even better, you know.
This is a project of the Research and Training Center on Independent Living at the University of Kansas. It is funded by the National Institute on Disability and Rehabilitation Research. For more information, contact Amanda Reichard, Ph.D., REICHARD at KU.edu, or Muriel Saunders, Ph.D., MSAUNDRS at KU.edu. The Research and Training Center on Independent Living, the University of Kansas, 4089 Dole Center, 1000 Sunnyside Avenue, Lawrence, Kansas, 66045. Phone 785-864-4095. Touchtone phone 785-864-0706. Web www.rtcil.org, then click on Research and the KU Diet Project.